Howdy, howdy, howdy. I am glad to be here. Hope you are too. I'm excited. It's been a while, and if you've been following, you know that we've been working on the house and trying to get it back to normal, and still don't have my office set up in the house yet, but we have floors now for the most part. All but two rooms have floors, and so we're living high and having fun like the rich people do. And so have a kitchen now. So I'm excited about that. I put that in the notes for this video about going live because I wanted to share that with you. So expect some, eclairs or something in the mail soon because I'm going to be sending you something. Anyway, it's a beautiful day outside. I wanted to come on here and do a Q&A and talk to you and visit with you a little bit and kind of go through some things that I've been getting because I'm still active. Just because I don't come on YouTube and don't come live on Facebook doesn't mean I'm not here. Hey, Ken, it's good to see you. Bob's in the house. Good to see you. Somebody said, yo, stud. I like that. My head just got bigger. Did you see that? It wasn't a camera trick. So anyway, I'm still live. You know, I'm in the group every day at vendorsunited.com, and we do a live Q&A Monday nights and on Thursday nights. And all the vendors, you know, we discuss stuff and we discuss problems and we discuss solutions and we come up with the tips and tricks because times is a-changing. Don't know if you noticed, but times are a-changing. And so one of the biggest things I've gotten is Ben, gas prices are high. I can't even afford to take my card out. Well, I can tell you the solution, okay? I'll tell you the solution to all this. And then another one that's popping up is that because of the way it is, because COVID still exists and there's 50-something variations and all the worries around it, you have more opportunities than you've ever had. And I know you're thinking, well, Ben must be smoking something good today. Because he somehow turned into a poop show into something positive. But the truth is, I'm getting to watch thousands of vendors. I'm getting to correspond with and talk with and visit with thousands of vendors. Well, the benefit of that is I see the industry in a whole for the country, even Canada and other countries even, but mostly in the United States. Well, what's happening with vendors is the ones that are taking this opportunity by the horns are killing it. And you go, well, how? Because the cost of goods went up. Cost of goods being your supplies and your hot dogs and your lemonade and your lemons and your sugar. Everything's gone up. I'm sure you've noticed, okay? And unless you just are super, super wealthy, you notice when you go to the gas station and grocery store that everything is ridiculous. I went to Taco Bell yesterday. I was talking to him last night in the VU meeting. I went to Taco Bell. It's $2.67 for a taco. For a taco that used to be 88 cents. $2.67. So three tacos for a person because they're smaller now. Don't know if you noticed that. Everything got smaller. You know, McDonald's had the sausage burrito. I love those things. And they're little tiny things. You know, they were about 8 inches long. Well, now they're about 2.5 centimeters long, and you got to have a 14 pack to even taste one. And so things are changing. Well, how does this help you? Because people are used to it, just like you are. When you go to Walmart grocery store, you go to Publix or Ingles or whatever, Winn-Dixie, whatever your Food City, Food Line, wherever you're going to shop groceries. You know that prices have gone up, but you ain't going to the front register going, hey, I ain't paying this. I ain't paying it. I ain't paying $6 for a dozen eggs. You are paying it. We've all we know that we have no control, no power. And so we're paying that debt, right? So we're just doing it because we have to. We have to feed our kids. We have to feed our grandkids. We have to feed the chickens. We just have to keep living. So same goes for you. As a vendor, you should be raising your prices right now to 3 to 4 times cost, current cost. Why so much? Because it gives you wiggle room. 4 times gives you a lot of wiggle room. Talked to a vendor last night, they were about 6 times cost. And that gives them wiggle room that if prices fluctuate or go up, they don't have to tell all their customers, sorry, hot dogs went up a quarter, or hot dogs went up 55 cent now, we had to go up on our prices. No, they're absorbing that because they're making more profit today. And even if prices continue to rise, which they're going to through at least the fall, we're going to see prices rise. So why not go ahead today and protect yourself? Protect yourself from having to check like a stockbroker, oh, what's the stock at today? Okay, hot dogs today, well, at least till noon, hot dogs are going to be $2. Tomorrow, they're going to be $2.11. At 3 p.m., they're going to be $3.19. Instead of doing that with your customers, just make it $4 or whatever it is. People will pay. I shared with the Vendors United Group, the members there, this past Sunday was at a place, you know, and they had a hot dog vendor. And the hot dog vendor was charging what? How much was it?
$12.
$12. $12 for a hot dog. Okay. My girlfriend's son, he's 4 and a half, almost five. I have to say almost five because I'll get in trouble by him. He's almost five. And he ate two of those. Two of those. I got a picture to prove it. Because he crammed them in his mouth. I don't know why the kid was so hungry. But the bottom line is $24 in hot dog just for him. And that didn't include a big drink or anything. I think the drink, I don't remember the drink price, but it was like $8.50 or something for a 24 ounce drink, but then $2.50 for refills. Well, people paid it because we were there expecting to pay high prices. And if you didn't, you just weren't there anyway. So the point is people treat themselves. We often treat ourselves with food. I want to ask you a question, and I want you to think about this real quick. When you are out right now, you go to work every day. If you've started vending, then you work your butt off. And if you work in a coal mine, it's kind of easy for you. I'm just kidding. But you work your butt off. What do? When the weekend comes or your day off comes, the first thing you think about doing is treating yourself. We treat ourselves to food. We go, you know what? I deserve to go to the Outback today. I deserve it. I've worked hard all week. I'm going to the Outback. We've done a good job this week. And you treat yourselves. And you don't worry about the price. You may complain about it, but you still go. Well, people are doing that. So you need to do that. You need to go, not take advantage of people. Don't make your hot dogs $49. I'm saying take this opportunity to raise your prices so that you're protected, because the ones that don't will not be here next year. They won't be here. They will be back working in the coal mine or working as a truck driver or taking a job with the county as a sheriff's deputy or whatever else. But they will now have gone back to a rigid set of hours and a rigid job with not the freedoms that we get as vendors. As vendors, we get the freedom to work when we want. We get the freedom to go, you know what? I'm going to raise my prices and I'm going to work 3 days a week. I've got vendors. One's Caitlin, okay? Caitlin today posted a thing that said she's paying $20 an hour plus all tips to run her cart. She already has gobs of customers. So whoever gets to that opportunity is going to make a buck ton of money. And you go, well, why is Caitlin not running it? Well, Caitlin has been running it for years. She took her whole family on a vacation. I shared that with you. She is in a little town in Ohio, but the point is she was a Dollar General manager and like a district manager. So she covered a bigger territory and worked, you know, 195 hours a week because you don't have a schedule. You just have to be everywhere. And you know what that's like if you've ever managed anything. It's a great name tag to say manager, but that means, hey, we're going to work you like a slave for $3.10 an hour because we can, because your salary now. So Caitlin, I get back on my story. Caitlin started at the beginning of COVID, started doing cottage food. So she created meals and health. Then she went to healthy meals. And she started just catering to people who wanted healthy meals. So once or twice a week, she sends out menus on Facebook and people order the meals, and they come by and pick up the meals. She's got now an official commissary kitchen where she's producing meals, and she's gotten so busy that she's offering $20 an hour to run her cart for 2-3 hours a day on the days that it runs, and you get all the tips too. Well, other vendors are doing the same. Caitlin's just top of mind because she posted that this morning and I saw it. So I want to tell you, this business is phenomenal right now. Restaurants are struggling. The ones that haven't raised their prices are struggling. Taco Bell ain't struggling. You ever been to a Chick-fil-A recently? The line's still long. Their prices are up. Their servings are down. And yet we're all still in line at the Chick-fil-A and at the Taco Bell and at the McDonald's. So you have the opportunity right now to set a pace for yourself so that you are ahead of the game next year. This won't be a crippling story for you. You'll look back and go, you know what? Those are bad times. This president was in office and this happened and this happened and COVID and my neighbor's chickens was having puppies and everything was going to hell in a handbasket, and I didn't just still make it. I succeeded my expectations, and you have that opportunity right now. And I'm not blowing smoke. I'm telling you that vendors are doing it more than I've ever seen vendors do it. Vendors are killing it. Y'all know my friend Jason Brown, been in the business for years, and Diz's Dogs and Corey Lawrence with O'Doggies and all these people, but there's more than them. But Jason, the reason I brought him up is he's helping a vendor today. It will be, helped him yesterday. His first day is this weekend, running a food truck. I think he's 10, by himself, because they have other gigs going. So they've worked with this kid to run his own setup. If a 10-year-old can do it, you and I can do it. We've done it. We've done harder crap. Sometimes because we put ourselves in a bad situation, sometimes just by the luck of the draw, sometimes just with the circumstances we had to be in a bad situation, like helping Mama move and you didn't realize she had 16 outbuildings and you had to help her clear those out too, and you got in over your head. Vending, if you do this right and you raise your prices now and you go, you know, I had vendors last night private messaging me during the thing, Ben, I can't raise prices because my area just can't afford it. It's hard times here. Guess what? It's hard times freaking everywhere. Everybody's not going to come every day to your cart because they can't afford it. I can't afford to go out to eat every day. That's ridiculous. Okay? But I can go out on Friday night or a Tuesday and go, you know what? I'm going out to dinner tonight. I deserve it. I worked my butt off this weekend. I answered 11,000 emails. I did this. I'm going to treat myself. And we don't worry about the price. We just go do it. There's people like that all around you doing the same. Be out there. Be consistent. If it's 2 days a week, 1 day a week, whatever you do, and make those big dollars. There's vendors out there making, I kid you not, astronomical money, more than I ever made with my carts, ever. I can't believe how well vendors are doing right now. And it's because they seized an opportunity. There's about 35% of the restaurants in America are closed, okay? There's limited hours on almost 80% of the American restaurants and fast food chains, limited hours. You've never had a better opportunity to make money and to set yourself up for success. So it doesn't mean go out and work 7 days a week. Don't have a $900 day and go, dang, that was a busy lunch. We made $913 and I'm going to be open 7 days a week. Don't do that. You'll burn yourself out. Pick a couple days a week, maybe three, and work those days. Do it like Mark Lawler. Mark Lawler is one of our VU OGs, been around forever. He was vending before I was on YouTube. And he goes out and he picks the days he's going to do it. And he picks the catering events and he picks the special things he wants to do. And that's what he does, and he makes a good living. And you can do the same. So if you're thinking about any of that vending stuff, you can go to learnhotdogs.com, because I know it says hot dogs, but it covers everything from kettle corn. You can search kettle corn, you can search lemonade, you can search donuts, you can search anything in the search box, and it'll pull it up. Okay. Vendorsunited.com on the screen right here is all of the stuff where I'm talking about the vendors that we have the meetings privately with every week. So I want you to take note of this and make those changes. It may be hard for you. It may be a tricky deal. It took Jason Brown with Love Food Trucks to get me, at the time it was called Love Hot Dog Company, and it took him about a year to talk me into raising my prices when I was vending full-time. It took him about a year to get me to raise my prices. Now, I had helped Jason get going in this, and yet he's given me advice. And I took his advice reluctantly, and I all of a sudden had more customers, because raising prices does two things. It makes you more money, but it makes customers know you're serving quality, and you know what you have, and you're gonna do it. It's the difference between a $3 pack of men's socks for Father's Day and a $22 pack of men's socks for Father's Day. So keep that in mind. And I want to tell you this too before I start answering questions. Happy Father's Day to all those dads, and to all you that have dads. Happy Father's Day. Now, let me go try to get some questions answered here. Lyman, thanks for being here. That's the Funnel Cake King. Lyman's in the VU group and has helped. He helps people daily. I'm going to be interviewing Lyman soon. He agreed to it about 2 months ago when I was going to do it, and then I got busy and neighbor's chickens were having puppies again, and I didn't get to it. So, Ola Ben from Oregon, Amerimax. I like that name, Amerimax. That's like American and Mexican. See, us hillbillies can figure stuff out. Alan Anderson, preach it, brother. Thanks for being here, Alan. I appreciate it a bunch. James, ordered my cash cow, have everything done, just waiting to get it here. Grady's grub coming soon. That makes me happy, James. And I can't wait to see how you do. Now you know what to do before you set out that first menu is raise your freaking prices. If hot dogs cost you 40 cents, you need to be at $3 minimum. Okay? You may want to be 4 or 5. We got vendors selling them at 7 and 8 and 9. So go figure. If Taco Bell, for a 20-cent taco, maybe 18-cent taco it takes them to make, that's smaller than it used to be, can get $2.67, you can do this. Hello from London. Les Terry in the house. Thank you for being here. Or it's Lee. I'm sorry. I said Les. I have contacts in, and because I'm old, they put a bifocal close one up in my left eye, and in my right eye, they put my distance one. So my brain has to play this thing. So my reading skills haven't done so well so far. Lee, thank you for being here. And I just wanted to apologize for saying less. Manny, you recently mentioned new state rules in Florida regarding hot dog vendors or vendors in general. Manny, there has been changes in Florida. The governor signed, DeSantis signed a deal. This has been a year ago. A deal where, and it's now in effect, where cities can't restrict vending. They can't say, we don't allow it, because they're violating federal law, is the bottom line. So DeSantis really just backed up the federal law and saved you the hassle of having to sue a city. Let's see, Reserve New Mexico, thanks for being here. We are just followers of the economy and inflation, absolutely, but get ahead of it. Alan, about Herenzi? We are just followers of the economy and inflation. Don't be a follower. Instead of being reactionary to things, like, oh my gosh, I went to go get my hot dogs this morning. They've gone up 55 cents. Well, don't be reactionary. Go ahead and plan ahead for it. You will not lose customers. You will have more customers, new customers, and a better time going home, going, man, it's tight, it's tight. Nope, I've got vendors going, oh my God, I've never made so much money. Now, is their money going as far as it used to? No, dollar for dollar, it's not. But because of the economic times, they've swapped that money. They've changed it so that now's the time to be, and if you were at 2, now you may be at 5. Well, now you're literally taking home more value and more money in your pocket, not just a dollar for dollar switch off with inflation. James says, I'm going to start easy, regular, and jumbo dogs plus nachos. Perfect, James. That's how I recommend to start. Start off simple, add when you need to, or have a day. Thursdays maybe is your special day. O'Doggy started that. He started just doing a special dog on Thursdays. And then if it did really, really well for a couple Thursdays, he would add it to the main menu. Or he might not. He had some that he didn't add to the main menu just because when he posted, guess what, guys? I'm bringing this back, kind of like McDonald's McRib. You know, everybody freaks out and posting on Facebook. They don't care about their dog taking a poop in the yard and sending a picture to everybody. They now are telling you about the McRib's back and we got to go and everybody's in line at McDonald's for the McRib. He did some of his dogs that way. And that helped. Let's see. My city keeps adding. I got to pull this up here where it's bigger. My city keeps adding new rules saying we can't use this, can't use California rules, says we can or can. I go starting them. Why is that yellow to me? I think it's just the background. Anyway, setting them straight, go to learnhotdogs.com. And type in the word justice, and it will tell you what to do to suss out the information. Here's where I'd start first, though. Go to learnhotdogs.com/liar. So put the little /liar, and that should solve that. And then you can always email me, Marty. Some places require that you have a service kitchen to operate a food cart. Yes, guess what? Guess what, Hux? Every state in the nation, all 50, okay, and 49 if you don't count Alabama, all states require a commissary kitchen. Every state does it. Some health inspectors don't understand and will let you get by without one, okay? I've got a buddy in Knoxville, Tennessee. He ain't got one because his inspector said, you got 4 sinks on your cart. You don't need a commissary kitchen, which is, I like his logic, but it's against the code. The code says you still have to have one. So I want you to keep that in mind that all states require that. But I tell you how to get them. Easy and free. Take me a good dog over chain fast food meal any day. Brian, that you nailed it. Because here's what's up. Is people like nostalgia, people like feeling good, people like having something unique and different. But with hot dog vending, street food vending, period, of any sort, whether you're doing street corn or you're doing kettle corn or you're doing funnel cakes, it is a unique experience. It's why we go to state fairs and county fairs and we love them and we go directly over to where they're cooking because we like it. And I'm speaking for all of us because I know you do, okay? I'm confident in that. Let's see, I get $7 for a Chicago dog, $9 for a combo. Nobody blinks an eye. I pay $15 an hour for help. I want you to look at that. Jennifer Fisher, thank you for sharing that. See, this is what Vendors United vendors do. They share this in the group and we get to kind of change our line of thinking because now we've got somebody that's proven and done it. And so it helps us all. Jennifer here is, and here I am in, you know, I'm on Facebook right now and on YouTube right now, and she's it's nice enough to share her real numbers. I'm getting $7 for a Chicago dog, $9 for a combo. And she's telling you nobody blinks an eye. And she's paying $15 an hour for help. That way she keeps good help. She's showing them, hey, I care about you, and I appreciate you being here, so I'm going to pay you good. And I like that. Jennifer, thank you for sharing that. Lyman's right about Marty's question. Just started our lemonade pop-up tent last weekend. Lemonade only grossed 806 hours. Congratulations, Nelson. That is awesome. Awesome. See, it's stuff like that I get in the in emails, and it just eats me up. It makes me so happy to see the successes out there. That is fantastic. Where else have you gone and worked and made $800 in 6 hours? And that's their first time. They're only going to get better. They're only going to get better. 27 kitchen manager here. Plan on being a vendor in a year or two. Your videos are helping me get out there. You know what's cool? Sirianni is, I hope I pronounced that right. I think that's Sirianni for a president. I don't know what that means, but you know who I'm talking to. Here's what I would tell you. We have vendors that just start one day a month and just vend one day a month and are tickle pink with it. Michael Wood started and he said, I'm only going to work 2-3 days a month. That's it. Well, then he started making so much money. 2-3 years later, he's doing it full time and going crazy. And so my point is that don't sell yourself short. If you think you don't have enough time, you don't have to take all the jobs. You don't have to take all the catering events that you're asked for. You can raise your prices, go out there and have fun with it and make it a hobby and make a whole nother, entirely nother income with 2 or 3 days a month. Michael Wood did it in a small podunk town where they ain't even got indoor bathrooms in Georgia. I'm just kidding. They do have indoor bathrooms. They just don't have electricity yet. So let's see here. Skip, thank you a bunch. Kind words. I appreciate it a bunch. Cynical Fitness. I bought hot dogs yesterday here in California. The dog was $8. Guess what? If I had to buy all again from that cart, now I would suggest five or six, I'd still go back. Well, thank you for sharing that. Also, we talk a lot. We did last night on the Vendors United group about your attitude. Attitude makes a big difference. If you're overworked, you cannot have a good attitude. You almost dread going out with the cart because nobody tells you this except me. I'll tell you this, and VU members tell you this, is it's a lot of work. And the ones that are doing it will tell you it's a lot of work. There's still prep time, cleanup time, go get supply time, all that stuff. So you may be out there 2 days a week or 3 days a week for 2 hours a day, but you had a lot of time in between that you were doing other stuff that made all that happen, right? So you have to take that into account. But if you wear yourself out, you can't be in a good mood. You can't be positive. You want to go out there and be like razzle dazzle, like a freaking clown and have fun with people. If you've seen the videos of Michael Wood cutting up with customers and Mark Lawler cutting up with customers and Jason Brown cutting up with customers, it's a blast. Make it a blast. If you're making good money and you aren't overworked, you will have a whole different attitude. And that attitude will bring more customers, make you more busy, but it may mean now you, instead of working 3 days a week, you work 2 days a week because you got more customers and you don't need the third day. And now you're in a better mood because that's 5 days of fishing in my book. And so that's extra free days. David says, how much for a bun length all beef loaded? It's a good question, David, but it depends on where you are and what kind of dog. Is it an all beef, a premium dog like a Salins or a Boar's Head? Or from a private, you know, a local company that makes good hot dogs, like we have one here. Are you getting it there? Or did you make it yourself? Did you make your own hot dogs? Or did you go get one at the Piggly Wiggly that were the discounted almost expired dogs? So all that changes, but it also changes where you are vending. So if your economic situation in your town, if the... Let's say you're in a poorer community, and I'm going to just use an example. West Virginia, there's some poor, poor communities where if you said $8 for a hot dog, they'd probably choke, but they also don't have any Taco Bells and Wendy's in town either. So they're eating potted meat, a lot of them. Well, they don't need an $8 hot dog. They need a $3 hot dog. So it depends on what you're going to serve. So you serve to your demographic. But no matter what you're doing, you need to be at 4 to 5 times cost. I know I said 3 to 4 earlier. I changed it because I've now built you up. Now you may not have noticed my slick move. 4 to 5 times cost. So 4 to 5 times. So if you're buying a package of ballpark all beef franks, right, and you've loaded it up and those condiments cost you about, let's say, 60 cents, but you round it up to a dollar to be safe for price inflation. So now you're at, you've got this all beef pack that you bought 8 dogs for $3, let's say you paid, okay, by bulk. You bought it in bulk because you can go to your local grocery store and buy it in bulk. So now you can be $3, I don't know, eight into three. I don't know what that math is. It's probably about 45, 50 cent a hot dog is my guess. So 45 cent a hot dog plus your condiments at a dollar, let's say, and your wrappings and your napkins and all your stuff, the cost of goods sold. And now you're at $1.50, maybe $2. Well, then you need to be at 5 or 6. So you need to look at the math and also look at the area, the demographic of the area. Now, the demographic can change by different side of town. So you can also do it that way. And don't tell me about people that, oh, the gas station sells 2 hot dogs for $2. We can all go to a gas station. If you want a gas station hot dog, have at it. I've had them. They suck, but they'll do in a pinch. You ain't serving gas station hot dogs, so don't be trying to compete with prices with them, okay? So don't ignore that. Truck drivers may like that every now and then. I even may like that every now and then. I'll get one every now and then off a roller grill, hoping it was put on in the last month. But the bottom line is, I don't want that every day. And I'd much rather pay $3 more for a real good hot dog from a vendor like you. My daughter went up to the Bay in North Cali, San Francisco, $12. Holy cow, $12. Marty, thanks for sharing that. That was what I experienced the other day in the mountains of North Carolina, okay? Near Blowing Rock, North Carolina, they were selling hot dogs for $12. So that gives you an idea. I retired June 30th. I recently talked to Tori. I plan on buying your large trailer. Lee, congratulations. And you're going to love it. You're going to love it. If you follow the steps, there will not be an ounce of chance of failure. Will you have some bad days? Yeah. But you'll never fail. You'll always just grow. So keep that in mind. Good morning from Illinois. Doing my second lemonade shake-up tomorrow. That's awesome. Lemon shake-ups. It's lemonade. And I love it. And they call them shake-ups because we put raw sugar in there and shake it up. And now you're delivering a fresh squeeze lemonade, and people love them, and they're paying out the butt for them. We've got vendors in the group getting $11 for a 32-ounce one of those. 32-ounce with ice. So they're mostly buying ice because a 32-ounce cup with normal cubed ice, little square ice, you'll get about 14 to 15 ounces of lemonade in that glass. And then refills for $5. So... let's see. The political bent here is sad. I don't know what that means, but I'm sorry. If you're in the comment section and you talk politics, just go. We ain't here for politics. I don't care who you voted on. I don't care where you go to church. I don't care about any of that crap, because when it all boils down, if I'm driving down the road and you're in a ditch flipped over in a car, I'm not going to check to see who you voted on. I'm not going to check to see if you go to the same church as me or you worship the same God as me or anything. I'm going to help you because it boils down to we're all human and I love you and I'm going to just help you. And I believe for the most part that you are too. I believe that we all have that in us, that we ain't checking at the house fire when there's people running out and we're grabbing people and helping. We ain't checking who they voted for. We just move on and love one another. And that's what it comes down to, is just move on. You don't have to like everybody. Just love everybody. I was told as long as I can, wasn't all the big pans as portable concession sink, I don't need a commissary. That is possible. I've had vendors do it. Lots of vendors, not just a couple. I mentioned one in Knoxville, but that's just the one that came to my head, off the top of my head. How do you feel about Food Truck Association that gets spots for you? Cost to join $180 a year. I say show me the numbers. I'd call them up and go, hey, if it works that good, let me call some of your vendors. Let me call some of the people that are already members and do it. I think that's great if it works. We've had vendors in our group do that, create local food truck, like Jason created the conspiracy food truck group, okay, in his Pennsylvania area. And he then got the bookings because everybody knew from what's her name, Jay-Z and Beyonce, that their team knew that Jason was the go-to for a concert for the not for the crowds, for them and their crew and staff, the backstage people, to be able to eat. So they'd call and Jason go, okay, I've got this food truck, and I can send those there. And it, those things are doable. And he walks you through that in VU. He's got a video on how he set it up, how to do it, how other people have used his stuff to do it in their towns. You don't need to do a nationwide one or something. I think that's maybe overkill. I would do a local one, but you could create your own local one. In your case, if you think it'll help you, ask them to prove it. Say, let me talk to some of the members. Let me see who's in your group. I want to talk to them. I want to see how much business you brought them. There's nothing wrong with that before you pay $180. Would $5 a dog be too expensive? Absolutely not. I just paid $12 a piece for dogs last Sunday in the mountains. So Mark Dennis, congratulations. I'm glad you're doing your due diligence and good luck with your thing. You'll be fine. You'll be prepared. Don't worry. Get my foot in the door and take the events and such, get my product out there and then see where my direction is afterward. Great idea. I love it. Look at this. David says I've been selling for 7 years. I see all kinds of prices. I just want to know what others selling their bun length all beef. Can somebody please, I'm setting up 5 loading loaded, 7 for a meal, 10 for 2 dogs. Am I ripping myself off? Someone please. David, don't, here, I can tell you, I could throw out any number and have 100 vendors to back up that number. I could tell you, look, a loaded dog, bun length, all beef, $8. And I can find you 100 vendors that I know people, I mean, know personally, that I've communicated with, at least 100 that are charging that. But I could also find you some that are charging 4. I could find you more that are charging 4. So it does it matter really? Does it matter if you do it 4 or 8? What I'm saying is if you'll use the numbers, look at your cost, and go 5 to 6 times as much, and you will come out ahead. You will come out ahead, and it won't, you won't be shooting yourself in the foot. It doesn't matter if the vendor that the person shared a minute ago that was charging 12 in California for a hot dog, and if your area doesn't support 12, it doesn't matter that they're getting 12. You're not shooting yourself in the foot because you ain't in California. I'm just guessing. And I'm not trying to be mean. I'm just telling you, base it on your local area and your cost of goods. So if your costs are lower, then you may be able to sell it lower and still make 4 or 5 times your cost. New vendor, thanks for the information. It's really nice and helpful hearing things I didn't even think of. I love it. Go to learnhotdogs.com and I'll overload your brain with all kinds of things that we think we know, but then we go, crap. And if you're a brand new vendor, go to learnhotdogs.com/40. It's the top 40 questions I get asked, and I redo it every year. Top 40 questions I get asked by new vendors. And you'll go, holy crap, I didn't think about that. I didn't think about that. Because what happens is we run into it, and then we think about it because we didn't know to even think about it because we just don't know to know. Let's see, Mike, the captain. Yeah, he's back. Thanks, Mike. Best thing I ever did was getting a hot dog cart. Thank you for saying that. I'm with you. It's why I wrote a book, Hot Dog Saved My Life, because it did, literally. And it changed everything. Dogwood Street's in the house. I live in a $3 town. Frankie, nothing wrong with living in a $3 town, okay? What would tick you off, though, is a Jason Brown or a Mark Lawler show up and get $4 in your same town. And then you'll be like, crap, I've been leaving a dollar on the table every time. If you live in a $3 town, figure out what the lowest cost is and if you have wiggle room for inflation, because things are going to happen over the next even 6 months. It's going to get worse before it gets better as far as our inflation problems. Either way, protect yourself so you're still in business. I'd rather you sell less dogs and be at $4 or $5 a dog and sell a good meal, sell less dogs, work less hours, and still be in business next May, next June. I'd rather see you still in business, but I thank you for saying that, because that I told Jason Brown, this was years ago, I said, dude, I can't get over $2 for a hot dog. Ain't nobody gonna pay $2, over $2 for a hot dog. He goes, Ben, just do it. He ragged me for a year. He ragged me publicly in our group, and I just couldn't do it. I couldn't make myself do it, okay? And I finally did it. I raised the prices, and here's how stupid I am. I literally put out a sign apologizing for having to raise my prices. Jason told me not to put out no sign. He just said, raise your prices. He goes, very few will ask, and then you just explain, cost of goods went up. Everything's up. So this was years ago, okay? And so this was after the last depression recession thing in 08 kind of deal. And so I go in and I go, okay, I'm going to raise them to three. Guess what happened? I got more customers. I didn't get any feedback crappy. There was a couple every now and then. Man, your prices. Some of my regulars, they were like, you raised your prices. That's a lot of money. And I go, yeah, prices, you know, keep going up. And they go, yeah, prices are up everywhere. And that's how it went. And nobody was like, I ain't coming back. They may come back less because maybe they personally can't afford it. But don't shoot yourself in the foot and go, well, I couldn't stay afloat. Everybody wanted a $3 hot dog. Well, everybody right now wants $2 gasoline. There ain't nobody going, well, I ain't buying gasoline. I just gonna sit at the house for the rest of my life. No, we're all still figuring out a way to buy the stupid gasoline at $12 a gallon or whatever it is now. It's ridiculous. I think it's five average right now across the country. Feels like 12. Let's see. I live in Arizona, sell all beef dogs links for six and combos for nine and 11 with chili cheese. Do you think this has to change? I want to make sure. It's too cheap. I don't think that's too cheap. I'd still go back to the logic of what I just shared is take your real cost. You must know your real cost and your time value and go, am I making my 4 to 5 times or even 6 times cost? Am I protected for the rising prices and the changes that are going to come? Because we also are going to cull our market down a little bit. People that used to go out to eat twice a week may be going out once a week now. People that used to go out every day, now not so much. I got a son that used to have to go to McDonald's every day. Well, times are changing. And he's figured out that truck he drives costs gas. And that it's costing him more in gas to drive to McDonald's than it does to buy at McDonald's. And he's decided that one day a week for McDonald's is good enough instead of his normal 12 times a week. I got a chance to sell on a college campus. Do I still need to have a commissary since I'm on private property? In some states, yes. All states require commissary. They're going to want to know whether you're on private property or not. They're going to want to know that you have a place clean and safe that's inspected to clean up and prep and do your stuff that you can't do from a cart. So I'd say, yes, you're still going to have it. What if the college would let you use theirs? Guarantee they have a kitchen in there that gets inspected and they might let you use it. There's churches, there's VFWs. There's so many ways to get a commissary. We get $4 for a plain, $6 for the quarter pound. Upsell chili, kraut, and cheese, $1. Alan, thanks for sharing that. That's good advice, and it helps other people know what others are doing. And Alan says, charge as much as your market will bear. And I agree with that. And you may even raise it just a hit more than that. And just get, do not gouge. Yet it's not like you go, oh, we got you trapped in here for this concert, Billy Ray Cyrus. And we got you trapped in here and the drinks are $55. No, don't gouge people. But do it in a way that it's profitable and safe for you and gives you cushion enough for the rising prices to come. My grand opening is tomorrow. I wish you could be there with me, Ben. Thank you for your advice and videos. You're the man. thank you so much and congratulations. That'll be exciting. Please email me pictures. Take a couple pictures. Take a moment. Have a customer give my free hot dog and say, take a picture of me and get a picture. Send it to me, please, so I can share it. And let me know how it goes. You can email me, Ben@VendorsUnited.com if you want, and I'd love to see it. Almost done with my cart build. How far are the burners placed? I'm at 10 inches. I have no idea, Mike. I apologize. I do not know that answer, but I know that Michael Woodward, or if you just email Keith@hotdogcartstore.com, he can tell you. He's the engineer and he knows. He'll tell you how deep to put it and how the spacing. I just don't know. I'm thinking Dallas is a great market for chili dogs. I would think any market's good for chili dogs with mustard on it. I don't even live in a town. We are in the woods in Western Kentucky, but it works. There you go. So here's David Ray vending. Doesn't live in a town, lives in the woods and vending. We have vendors around here that vend out in the outskirts. They're not in towns, and they make more outskirts than they do in the towns. I've got a friend that does coffee. She is in the same place every day. So when she's there, when she's open, she's in the same place. She's in the outskirts of town. She's 20 minutes from town. And she does coffee. Good luck out there, everyone, getting started up no matter what. Don't give up. Absolutely. Tennessee Highway Department said no way on the rest area vending. Going to see Keith to check out carts next week. Tennessee Highway Department said no way on rest area vending. You need to double check with the rest areas, because Tennessee Highway Department doesn't handle. They may be responsible for the rest areas, but they don't control the laws at the rest area. So federally, the DOT does. And the federal DOT, and I don't know if it's still in effect, but you can find out quickly and easily online, made a rule that vendors were welcome at the rest areas and off ramps that were wide enough on all interstates in the U.S. They did that at the start of COVID. So check into that. Awesome. Thank you. Anyway, I got to go. I know I've already been on here a bunch. I love you. I thank you for being here and bearing with me and all my little stories and sidetracking. But I wanted to share those two things I did at the beginning. And then I wanted to also answer some questions and hopefully inspire and uplift you to make these changes so that you will be talking to me next year at this time going, dang, Ben, I'm glad I did this, or I'm glad I did that. And not for my ego, but that helps. But if so that you're still in business, you're not looking for a job. You own your business. You own your job instead of your job owning you. I love you, and I'll see you soon. Bye.